And then, if I think we're over time, can you show this?
Oh, I don't think that will be an issue. So in my tradition, it all begins with the law of patika samupada, dependent origination. When this is existing, that comes to be. With the arising of this, that arises. When this ceases to exist, that ceases. So what that means is that everything comes about through complete interdependence. Everything is dependent upon everything else. Sometimes in Mahayana Buddhism, we describe this using a net. If you want, imagine a net, the horizontal threads of the net representing time, vertical threads representing space. And where each of these threads is meeting, there's a crystal. And each crystal is reflecting not only every other crystal, but every reflection of every other crystal. So just in that way, we're always coming into being together. We're composed of these reflections of each other. So from that place, we say Buddha was able to attain enlightenment because everything else was there. Our meditation practice is a path of radical inclusivity. In mindfulness, we train in finding out what we might be excluding and continuing to open to it. So just in that same way, how could there be real peace if it was exclusive to an individual or a community or a nation? You know, enlightenment, if it was going to be awakening, had to be shared by all. So just, they say, when Buddha got up from under the Bodhi tree, he exclaimed, "Wonderful, wonderful. Each thing has it. Each thing is already complete. So nothing hidden, everything interdependent. So the self and the physical world depend upon each other. And we, as a community of human beings, depend upon each other. So within that, implicitly, there's a connection of both love and responsibility. In order to receive peace, we first must have extended it. And so from that place, compassion isn't an intended action, it's a natural action. It comes out of a recognition that we're part of a greater whole, which is this web of life. So there's a traditional metaphor for the ways that Buddha taught the Dharma, where we say, just as the rain falls innumerable different ways, yet always has the same taste, so it is that the Buddha taught the Four Noble Truths, his sort of basic teaching, innumerable different ways, so that each being could receive the teaching in the way they were best suited to. So just in that way, as I open myself to people of other faith traditions, I listen to hear how those Four Noble Truths, you know, how the truth of the moment is expressing itself through them. And from that place, the intra-Buddhist dialogue is very often just as necessary as the interfaith dialogue, creating deeper connections across our Buddhist traditions, which very often have been separate geographically, linguistically, culturally. That very rich dialogue is now happening here in America to an extent we've never seen before in history. So from that place, I would say our vision of a culture of peace includes not only this interfaith dialogue, but also caring for the environment, not leaving anything out of our ecosystem. And from that place, when His Holiness the Dalai Lama was asked, "What's one thing we could do for world peace?" He said, "Well, you know, there's no one thing. It's not that simple. But to do one thing, start with ecology, you know, recycle, you know, save energy, simplify our lifestyle. You know, through this, a future is possible for the next seven generations. In our Wellesley College community, we've been working on an interfaith initiative connected with the White House, bringing interfaith dialogue about through the matrix of community service, recognizing the partnerships that take place when people are building the community, warm hand to warm hand, are really urgently needed and will create the just, beloved community we would like to live in. We've been working on an edible ecosystem together on campus. And in the same way that many plants together provide the nutrients, the ground cover, the very best optimum conditions for their mutual thriving, in that same way, one of my colleagues refers to the Guild of Plants as a diversity, that nature itself is showing us how we should model our society. And so through this, all of our students together generate some insight and compassion, a very tangible, hands-on awareness of interdependence. And in that way, the path really is the goal. You know, our journey is continuing. So thank you.
Thank you.